Hi guys, in this video I'll show you step by step how to build a quality 40 watt 95 plus CRI budget studio light with a 3D printed adjustable hanging arm to attach to the walls or ceiling. Fast and easy, for no more than 20 bucks. All the parts, materials and links to STL files are listed in the description. I'm building three of these lights for my workshop studio, so I thought it'd be a great idea to make a video about it. If you enjoy it, please give it a like. If you want to see more of my videos, feel free to subscribe to the channel and watch this video till the end to catch a glimpse into my next project. Finally, I would love to see your thoughts, so leave me a comment down below. And now, without further ado, let's get started. We begin with a stainless steel bowl to which we are going to attach an electrical plastic junction box. The box is 9x9 centimeters, roughly 4x4 inches, and about 5 centimeters or 2 inches deep. We need to cut a square hole in the steel bowl for the box to fit in. We'll use the box to mark the centers of the sides and then, with a pair of calipers, draw the rest of the square. Finally, we measure the 45 degree corner sides and mark those on the bowl too. After cutting and filing, we end up with something like this. Before attaching the junction box, we'll drill a 3mm hole in each side. Now we screw in the mounting screws. It would be best to also secure them with some CA glue. Next, drill a 6mm hole in the middle of the junction box. Install an M3 screw with a large head or with a washer to later secure the bulb socket assembly to the junction box. Drill two 4mm holes for the adjustable arm mount. You can also choose other mounting options. Now, attach the 3D printed adjustable arm mount using two M4 screws. Notice the M3 screw is free inside the hole. When we attach the socket assembly, we will tighten it using this hole in the mount. This is a regular E27 ceramic bulb socket with a 90 degree bent tin plate. We first straighten all the plates. Then bend back two of the plates at 90 degrees, but this time at the middle hole. Enlarge the first holes to 3mm to fit an M3 screw. Attach all sockets together with the M3 screw and fasten it with a 3cm long brass spacer. The other end of the spacer will have the junction box M3 screw inside. Next, let's wire the sockets. Hook all the neutral wires together on the sockets. And later, connect them to the power cable. Make sure to install ferrules if you're gonna use stranded wire. They also make joining two wires much easier. This end will join the power cable's neutral wire later. Now the live wires. These will go from the sockets to the switches. Better cut them longer for now and trim them later as needed. Attach ferrules to the ends that go into the sockets. And the assembly is done. Let's wire the mains plug to the power cable. This is a 230 volt plug, so depending on the country you're in, you might need a different type. But the procedure is somewhat similar. To strip the cable, bend it firmly and gently touch the blade to the outer jacket. You don't want to press on the blade. The jacket will strip instantly due to the bending pressure. Remove the isolation of the individual wires and install ferrules. Then, trim the ferrules as needed and tighten them. Further stripping of the outer jacket might be needed. This might not be the best way of attaching a mains plug to a cable, but it works well for me. gently cut a hole in the junction box for the power cable to go in, pull the cable through, and make a knot. We need to prepare a side of the junction box to receive the four switches. We need to manufacture and install a faceplate of some kind for the switches to go into. You can make it out of any sheet of plastic, metal, or other materials. For convenience, I will just 3D print mine. Link to the STL file available in the description. Now, press the switches in. Strip the outer jacket of the power cable right after the knot. Measure and remove the isolation of the live wire to form a copper bar. Then, tin this bar well. We also want to tin the switch's terminals for easy and fast soldering. Then, solder the copper bar to all four switches. For this type of switches, it does not matter which terminal is the input and which is the output. We really do not want to overheat these terminals, or they will just melt the plastic and destroy the switches. Before fitting the socket's assembly inside the junction box, we have to attach the power cable's neutral wire to the socket's neutral bus. With a ferrule, of course. Then fit the assembly, inserting the brass spacer into the 6mm hole in the junction box and screwing in the M3 screw tightly. Look and decide which switch controls which socket. Then trim, tin, and solder the live wires to the switches. Wiring done. Gently fit the faceplate to the junction box and drill two 2mm holes. Secure the faceplate with two screws. I used computer screws as I had them laying around. Now let's assemble the flexible arm. Connect the base to the first segment using an M4 screw and nut. Then connect the segments to each other and to the light itself using M6 carriage balls and nuts fitted inside the 3D printed knobs. Attach the base to the wall or ceiling using wood or drywall screws. These are 10-watt, 95+ CRI LED bulbs. CRI stands for Color Rendering Index. For professional photo and video applications, it's important to have the color rendering index at least 95 to capture the correct colors on your camera sensor. You can use the bulbs as they are or take the diffusion domes out. I chose the latter because I need a more direct light in my shop. If I later change my mind, I can either put the domes back or use a shower curtain or a softbox as a diffusion layer. Before plugging in, it's best to test it with a multimeter. Basically, beep means connection, no beep means no connection. First, the neutrals. All sockets' neutral terminals should be connected to the main plug's neutral prong. Then, with the switches on, measure all sockets' live terminals to be connected to the main plug's live prong. With the switches back off, there should be no connection between the live prong and the live terminals. Then again, with the switches on, there should be no connection between any live and neutral socket terminals. All checks out, let's install the bulbs and plug it in. If you don't have a multimeter, then visually double check, triple check, and quadruple check your connections. And there you have it, a 40-watt studio light on a flexible adjustable arm that you can position in any way you like to get your projects done. To get nerdy, with all three lights fully on, at ISO 400, I get an F8 on my lightmeter, which is perfect for my DIY projects because I need deep focus. By the way, I'm starting a really exciting new project. My dear friend and ex-band colleague has a very old guitar that sat on a wall for decades, and he now wants to make it playable. So he gave it to me, and I will not only repair it, but massively upgrade it with top-notch materials and hardware and make it not just playable, but transform it into a premium instrument. If this sounds interesting, subscribe to stay tuned. It's gonna be a fun video series. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a like and shared it with your friends. And if you need any additional info to actually build the lights, write me a comment. I'd be more than happy to give you a hand. See you soon!